stories in the most beautiful way. A couple of years ago, when I was much younger, and I thought myself wiser than I really was, I wouldn't read fairy tales. I still loved them, but I had no time for magic or fantasy or any of that sort of thing. I wanted to grow up. I wanted to know the real truth about life, about real people and their emotions. Fairy tales were not for me. Well, now I'm a little older, and I know a little better. And I realize I couldn't see the forest for the trees. There, in front of me, in fairy tales, were all the things I'd been looking for. The tale of Beauty and the Beast is one of those which make such awfully good sense in a charming and lovely way. Like all the great old stories of enchantment, it's a love story, which may not seem very unusual. But in Beauty and the Beast, many, many unusual and magical things happen. Some of them perhaps a little difficult to believe. But I don't think you're ever too old for fairy stories. In fact, the older you get, the better they get, and the more sense they seem to make. Perhaps of all of them, Beauty and the Beast says most clearly something all of us know in our hearts, yet too often forget. Like all good fairy tales, it begins. Once upon a time, there lived a wondrously beautiful girl. So lovely, in fact, that she could be called by no other name than Beauty. As good and kind-hearted as she was beautiful, she asked for only the simple things in life, but didn't even get many of these from a nice but rather bumbling father and two very selfish and ill-mannered sisters. The family lived in a tiny cottage on the edge of a dark and frightening forest. They had known better days, but now they had to live quite humbly. Once in a while, the father would visit a nearby city, and always when he returned, would bring gifts to Beauty's sisters, but seldom anything at all for her. Then one day, after such a visit, he realized how he had forgotten Beauty, and to make up for it, offered to take her into the forest to pick flowers for the house, a treat she truly enjoyed.
Thank you.
Beauty and her father had been into the forest many times, but on this particular day, they wandered deeper than ever before, until they were hopelessly lost. It was said that this forest was filled with bewitched animals and birds and other creatures, all ruled by a terrifying and hideous beast.
Thank you. Thank you.
And the beast cried. He had lost his love, and his heart was broken. But had he really lost her? All of his goodness and kindness had somehow touched Beauty. Though she didn't really understand why, she thought of him, of his unselfishness and generosity. But the beast knew nothing of her thoughts of him. He knew only that she was gone. And so he cried, and his heart broke. He fell into a deep trance, from which all the creatures of the palace and forest couldn't awaken him. Safe at home, Beauty knew none of this. Little had changed in the humble cottage on the edge of the great forest. Beauty's sisters were still selfish, and now they also seized with jealousy over the gifts the beast had showered on Beauty. She began thinking more and more of the enchanted forest and of the beast. Beauty sensed the meaning of the wilted rose. The beast was dying. Now her heart went out to him, and suddenly she wanted to be with him. She had to go to him.
Thank you.